I am so grateful to be here. I am immensely grateful to be here, to have been invited, and to just sit with these amazing, wonderful people around me. My heart is so full right now, just because I see the passion in everyone's just eyes, and Dr. Costin's eyes, and how he leads us, and he leads this incredible university. My name is Ashley. And I graduated in December 2019, so I'm really excited to be here and share with you guys just a little bit of my story. So 5 years ago, when my sister and her husband and myself and their family, when we moved here, we were looking for universities, and you know, we just kind of did the usual thing, just kind of applied here and there, and I forgot to tell you, I'm from Italy, so... Yeah, so we had no idea what we were going to find when we came here. So we just kind of said, all right, well, it's college time, so we're going to look for college. And so we kind of looked around, and let me tell you the two most determining factors that allowed me and my family to just choose this university. Number one, being an international student is so hard. And CSU made it so much easier than I ever thought. Charleston Southern was one of the very few universities that decided to fully take me along, just hold my hand through the process of, we're gonna fill out this form, and then we're gonna do this, and then we're gonna do that. It is so complicated, but Charleston Southern made me feel like I could do it. I can do this. And the second determining factor was scholarships. Fully and transparent, I can say this, scholarships. And part of it is, some of you may not know that international students don't get any sort of federal help at all whatsoever. So yes, the people at my table and a few other people are the actual reason I can stand here right now and call CSU my alma mater. Like, it's incredible for me to even experience that. And so thank you doesn't do justice. The words thank you really don't do justice to the contribution that they have made to my life, to my journey. And so I came in as an English major. I love words. I've always loved words and languages and things like that. And then later switched to communication, because I thought it'd be more applicable to what I wanted to do. And then God said, all right, if you're ready for me to actually tell you what I want you to do, you're going to go into ministry, music ministry. And so about a year before I graduated, before I was meant to graduate, God called me to music ministry. And I said, all right, Lord, I will graduate first, then I will do it. And he said, no, I want you to do it right now. I want you to pursue a music and worship leadership major in this school with these people around you. And so I did it. It was a leap of faith. And about 2.5 years after that, here I am. And God provided for me in a way that is incredible. And I don't want to take up any more time, but just thank you so much for being a blessing to my life. And I will make sure that I extend that blessing in all of the ways that God has given me to bless, which may be different for all of us. But I mean, students, the blessings that you have received to be in this room extended throughout your channels of influence, because we are also varied, and we're also different, and we have different talents and passions and callings. Use them. Just use them. And that's the best way I think you can thank the people at your table today. So thanks so much for having me.